someone waits for me.
The Bing Crosby Show, presented by Chesterfield. The Bing Crosby Show, produced and transcribed in San Francisco with John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, Judge Collins with the Mayors, and Bing's guests, Peggy Lee and Frank Fay, who has just completed a record-breaking run in Harvey. And now we bring you a man who has just completed a record-breaking run from the Greyhound bus station, Bing Crosby.
Yes, sir. And uphill all the way. But I got to correct you on one little point, Ken. I didn't take the bus into San Francisco.
Well, I knew you were down the Monterey Peninsula, so I figured you took the bus in.
No, I hitched a ride. Oh. I came in from Salinas on a load of lettuce.
You came in on a load of lettuce?
Delightful ride. I loved every moment of it. Of course, we did have a little trouble at the agricultural checking station.
What happened?
Well, the lettuce passed all right, but the inspector claimed I had a touch of Japanese beetle, and he was snide about it, too, he was.
Well, your trip did you a lot of good. I must say you're all shined up.
Oh, yes. You like my gimp?
Loosely.
This is cut off an old tablecloth from Julius's castle.
Bing, by the way, what's that cologne you're wearing? Taboo?
You like this?
No, I love it.
No, it's vegetable spray. But it does have an attractive odeur.
Oh, it's divine. Just divine. I wonder where I could get some of that.
Well, you just hop on a load of lettuce and fidget a little when you stop at the checking station. You'll get But enough of our picayune personal peccadillos. Matters of national importance engage our attention this evening. For instance, at the Mole, Peggy Lee moves in. Hi, Peg.
Hi, Bing.
Peggy, isn't it nice being up in San Francisco again?
Oh, it sure is a great town.
Great
I love
town.
It.
Favorite
you know,
town.
Bing, I have the very same room at the St. Francis Hotel that I had way back last winter.
How do you like the same room, huh? Mm-hmm. A great big hotel like that. You got the same room you had months and months ago. How could a thing like that happen?
I forgot to check out.
Oh, baby, you're going to have a hotel bill. It'll be a pip.
Yeah, but it'll cost me a lot of cabbage.
Well, if the St. Francis will take lettuce, I may be able to help you. Say, Peg, what do you say we hit a little music?
Okay.
Folks, here's a song called It's More Fun Than a Picnic. It's a live little tune from Mike Todd's Broadway show, As the Girls Go. It's more fun than a picnic, just being in love. You feel like the king of the Mardi Gras when you are in love.
It's more fun than a circus. You're playing the clown and shouting it out from the chimney tops all over the town.
It's more fun than running for president or making who's who. It's more fun than a barrel of monkeys when love makes a monkey of you and it do.
It's all peaches and rainbows, blue heavens above.
It's more fun than a picnic, just being in love.
It's more fun than reading the comic.
Oh, this is incredible.
And having a Coke in between.
Come up, Jack.
Or spending a nickel to buy a popsicle or tilting a pinball machine.
I'm only love.
It's more fun than blue jeans or yo-yo. And strawberry sodas and such.
We're living.
And toasting marshmallows is more fun with fellows. Yes, even when tweeting is Dutch.
It's more fun than being a movie star and seeing your face on the screen.
Or sinking that putt so you're under par, or tilting the pinball machine.
As grown-ups would say, it's colossal, and no one can tell us it's so. Why Rogers and Trigger, they don't even figure it's bigger than bubblegum.
Why, it's bigger than Los Angeles and the extended area, and that's that.
It's all peaches and rainbows.
Blue
heavens above.
It's more fun than a picnic, just being in love. Just being in love.
Peggy, Bing, and boys and girls, I want to tell you that was more fun than a picnic.
Oh, you're so adroit, Ken. What a clever way of putting it.
Well, it might have been a little square, but Bing, there's no need in being clever or tricky when you have a cigarette like Chesterfield to talk about.
No.
You see, it's as easy as ABC. Chesterfields are A, always milder than other cigarettes. B, better tasting, taste better than other cigarettes. And they're C, cooler smoking. Smoke cooler than other cigarettes.
Right, Ken. All you gotta do, folks, is smoke a couple of Chesterfields and see for yourself. ABC means smoking satisfaction. The right combination of everything you want in a cigarette. So smoke Chesterfields. They satisfy. Grab yourself a pack and join all the folks who say, Chesterfield is my cigarette. Sings the blues, pundits and such matters rise and face New Orleans reverently. Make me look good, Peg.
I've got a right to sing the blues. I got a right to feel low down. I got a right to hang around. Certain man in this old town keeps dragging my poor heart around. All I see for me is me.
Thank you, Peggy. That was wonderful. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present our guest of honor, a man who has long been among the nation's top wits, a man whose success on the stage is legendary. His most recent characterization of Elwood P. Dowd in the smash hit Harvey for the past 5 years has definitely established him as one of our great personalities. Here, then, is the great personality, Frank Fay.
Thanks, Bing.
Frank, it's good to see you. Really, it is. I suppose now that your play is closed, you must be out here in California to do the picture version of Harvey,
No, not Bing. They are not planning on me for the picture.
Oh, Frank. You were so good in the show. This is a terrible shock to me.
It's a worse shock to me. For you, it's just conversation, but I've got to live with it.
Well, I can't understand this, Frank. Who is going to play your part?
So far, it's a toss-up between Buster Crabb and Turhan Bey.
Well, that's Hollywood for you.
Hollywood's for you. Not for me, but I'll say one thing for them. With all the changes they're making in Harvey, they had the good taste the showmanship, and brilliance to keep the one big point authentic.
What's that?
The rabbit you didn't see in the stage show will be the same rabbit you won't see in the picture.
Shuckers, and that's the part I wanted to play.
A rabbit?
Yeah.
Well, Bing, with those ears of yours...
Now, wait.
And that family you have...
Get out! No, Frank, I can see how this whole thing... It must be a tremendous disappointment to you, huh?
Let's just say I'm happy for Turhan Bay.
Well, that's a quality that I really must admire in you, Frank. You're a real trooper. That's why it's such a pleasure to have you here as a guest.
Now, Bing, about that word guest, even though you refer to me as a guest, you are going to pay me, aren't you?
Oh, of course. Well, but, of course, we never make a big issue of money when you appear on this show. It's just like dropping in on friends and taking potlucks, you know?
Well, drop something in the pot, boy. Bing, as long as I'm a guest, and the money is vague.
Vague, yeah.
I'd like to ask you a favor.
Well, I'm glad they're able to grant it.
Now, you may not think it's much of a favor, Bing, but it's something I've been looking forward to ever since you asked me to take pot luck with you, as you put it.
What's on your mind, Frank? What is it?
Bing, I'd like to hear you sing.
Oh, you're ribbing.
No, I'm not. I'm on the level. I'd love to hear you.
Well, what song would you like to hear?
Do you happen to have one that you feel you do real well?
Well, I may have such a number, yes.
Song you feel comfortable in. Something you feel... fits you.
Well, I have a new number. I go for it. Well,
go ahead, Bing.
Okay.
Now, Bing, just one more thing. You don't feel as though I'm putting you on the spot.
No, no.
You're perfectly at ease.
Yes.
You're not worried about anything.
No.
You're doing good.
Well, I've had a nice season.
Well, you have a... you have a lovely family. Of course, there's a couple of blocks in Omaha you don't own. That shouldn't depress you too much. You're absolutely happy, right?
Yes.
Then go ahead and sing your song.
Okay. John, let's go.
Just What's one more thing. Pardon me just a second. Who is this fellow, John?
That's John Scott Trotter, our orchestra conductor. That's him there.
Yeah, I see him.
Mm-hmm. Hard to miss.
Now, Bing, this fellow John, he's a good leader, isn't he?
The best.
He himself, John, personally, has no worries or anything?
No. No.
This isn't the John with the other wife.
No, this is the John with the other stomach.
Correction, plural.
Yeah.
Well, then I guess you're all set to sing. You're going to do a song that you like, a song that you picked yourself. You have nothing on your mind, no problems. The orchestra leader has no problems.
No, but why all this? What?
Well, my point is this. If in your singing of this song, you should hit a clinker, it is your own fault.
Yeah, I guess so.
There'll be no excuses, no alibis?
No.
Then go ahead and sing, and I wish you well.
In the morning, out on the job, work like the devil for my pay. But that lucky old son has nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. I fuss with my woman, toil for my kids, sweat till I'm wrinkled and I'm gray. While that lucky old son has nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. Good Lord above, can't you know I'm pining? All my troubles away, like that lucky old son. Give me nothing to do but roll around heaven. Out on a job, work like the devil for my pay. But that lucky old son has nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. I fuss with my woman, toil for my kids, sweat till I'm wrinkled and gray. While that lucky old son has nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. Good Lord above, can't you know I'm pining? Tears all in down that cloud with a silver lining, lift me to paradise. Show me that river, take me across, and wash all my troubles away. Like that lucky old son, give me nothing to do but roll around heaven all
Bing, that was wonderful.
You're sweet.
Really? Sincerely, if I had known you were that good, I'd have done my stuff first.
What stuff is this?
Surely you've heard.
What?
I sing.
Well, then you can do me a favor.
What?
Sing me your favorite song.
Now, Bing, don't pin me down. I have two selections.
What are they?
Pale Hands and Stars and Stripes Forever.
selection there. You cover there. You run the gamut.
Yes. Now, which one do you want?
Aren't you up on any modern songs? Anything new?
Modern songs only annoy me. Where do they get those lyrics, those words?
Which one do you mean?
Some Enchanted Evening.
Beautiful number, really beautiful.
Will that fella John play the piano for me?
Oh, no, he's the leader.
Oh.
But he'll get in touch with the piano player.
John, touch the piano player.
Oh, no, no. Now, I have to tell him.
Oh, I see.
Union, you know.
I see.
Okay, John Scott.
Play for me, like I said, you know, with both hands, I'd like. Some enchanted evening, you may meet a stranger. Some enchanted evening, you may meet a stranger. How do you like that? Now, here's a guy who says he's enchanted. Now, when you're enchanted, everybody knows you're intoxicated. I know. I can remember when I was enchanted. Because that was a long time ago. But one time there in particular, I was enchanted for, oh, 5 or 6 weeks. And numb for I don't know how long. But this guy in the song insults your intelligence. He admits he's enchanted, and then he says, you may meet a stranger. You may meet a stranger. You're bound to.
You've missed the intent.
What?
You've missed the intent of the composers.
Bing, if you want to tell me about real estate or golf, that's all right. But don't tell me about enchanted.
That's all right, but I just can't let you insult the men who wrote that song. You really shouldn't insult men of that stature. They're geniuses, you know.
Don't be smug, Bing. I could have exposed you years ago, and I didn't.
For which I'm eternally grateful.
You should be. Do you know when they were raving about you at the beginning, when you were singing that song? When the blue of the night meets the gold of today. Someone waits for me. Now that to me is the most egotistical and ungentlemanly thing I've ever heard.
What way?
When the blue of the night meets the gold of the day. That's from night to dawn, ain't it?
Yeah.
Now just who do you think you are to keep a girl waiting? Night just for you to show up.
Well, I'm...
And with no necktie.
Oh.
If I could only see her. If you could only see her. I get it. You're enchanted.
Don't be absurd. You got the wrong boy.
No, I got a pretty good memory, Bing. I can place you. I remember on several occasions where you were enchanted plus.
Well, I might have been a little ethereal, Frank, but never. No enchanted.
Well, if that's how you want it, it's your program. But I can remember distinctly carrying ethereal from a taxi cab into the Edison Hotel.
I thought we took the cab with us.
Don't you remember they stopped us?
Well, anyway, Frank, we were just having a little fun. Besides, it was New Year's Eve.
You're close. It was the 4th of July.
What's the difference? Those were the days.
Boy, you remember how we used to harmonize?
Yes, Bing, I certainly do.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Good. And if you're going to sing, too, I guess we'll probably get the whole orchestra.
Irate.
It figures.
Dear old girl, the robins sing above you. Dear old girl, they sing of how I love you. The blinding tears are falling when I think of my lost pearl.
Do you mind if I take this?
Not at all, and you'll be good too, because I know.
My broken heart is calling.
Will you join me?
Love to.
Calling for you, dear old girl.
Real nice, Frank. You were in great voice.
Oh, that was really great, Frank. And, you know, I sure got a kick out of the way you tore those songs apart.
Well, thank you, Ken.
Do you know what would happen, Frank, if you tore a Chesterfield apart?
Well, yes. I imagine I'd have a good deal of difficulty smoking it.
Naturally, but what I'm getting at, Frank, is that if you tore a Chesterfield apart and analyzed it as you do a song, you'd find it contains the right combination of the world's best tobaccos.
And Chesterfield has a new special birthday gift carton now.
Yes, Frank, the Chesterfield birthday gift carton contains 200 milder Chesterfields. It's really a very attractive carton with pictures of Arthur Godfrey, Bing, and Perry Como on the cover.
Oh, joy, pull up a chair, Ned.
Mr. Fay leaps gleefully into the air. Let us remind you that you can make someone happy by remembering them with Chesterfield's birthday gift carton.
Chesterfield satisfy women and men. Chesterfield's over and over again. Milder, much milder, all smokers agree. Always buy Chesterfield's ABC.
Thanks, Peggy Lee, and Frank Fay, thank you for being aboard.
It was wonderful, Bing, and I got a particular kick out of being on your program up here. You know, I was born right here in San Francisco.
Well.
Yes, sir, right south of the slot. You see, Bing, I could have said that up earlier in the program and gotten a lot of sympathy, but I didn't. That's class. Good night, Bing.
Oh, good night, nothing. Let's go over to the Lido Club and catch Joe Frisco.
Now?
Yes, hope to see you next Wednesday, folks, when our guest will be Lum and Abner. Meanwhile, remember Chesterfield, the best cigarette for you to smoke. And thanks very much.
Crosby Show was produced and transcribed in San Francisco by Bill Morrow and Myrtle McKenzie. Tune into the Bing Crosby Chesterfield Show next week and hear Bing and his guests, Lum and Abner. The George Burns and Gracie Allen Show follows immediately.